Hello. So, I've been a little out of touch with everybody because I'm in the hospital and I've been here since Wednesday night, but I've been sick for about a week. I started with a fever, low-grade fever, and wouldn't go away for a week. And then it just slowly got a little bit worse and worse, but I haven't even been out of the house, so I figured, how in the hell, please, how's this even gonna, how do I get here? So, well, to give you guys maybe a little peace of mind for some of you that maybe do have symptoms, to start by saying, I did a COVID test and it did come back negative. The first test came back negative, but as they said, 70% of those tests, 70% accuracy on those tests. I'm currently being treated though for dual lung infection of pneumonia, glass shard pneumonia, and every morning I was waking up with a fever over 101 degrees. So, yeah. At this point, though, I'm starting to lose my marbles. So I thought that I would just create a live stream where you guys can ask me questions about what it's like in the hospital right now. And oh, yes, do you like my Pharaoh? This is my Pharaoh realness headpiece that I'm fully living for. Yes, right now. I got really tired of talking to the morphine shadows that were being cast around the room. So, yeah, how is everybody doing out there? I miss it, but the hospital here is actually really nice. So, I'm at St. Charles Mercy, and everybody's been really good so far. But oh my God, I am so bored. So freaking bored. I have no idea what to do. And they're doing more tests. I've got, how looks like this. They've taped it, retaped it. They have wax off half the hair on my arm every time. But I actually, yeah, all in all, I'm okay. So their biggest concern is my respiratory because I do have the shard glass pneumonia that they're trying to treat, which does go hand in hand with COVID-19. So that, along with fever and everything else, but the COVID swab came back negative. Now they are going to do another swab. They just did. Ugh. If you have not had it done, it's how do I put this? Fucking uncomfortable. So they shove this long, thin, Q-tip thing in your nose, all the way back into your eyeball, and they kind of sit there and wiggle it around. But yeah, aside from that, I'm hot. My body temp just keeps fluctuating from I can't get down below. Okay, 99 is pretty good, but I'm usually sitting about 102. So, I have made some pretty good friends, and you know me, I always try to find the most fun I can anywhere I am. I did just have them call my internal specialist and ask them if I could have wine. He said, no, I can. I'm not allowed to have wine. How negative. But I can have food and dessert. So if anybody wants to send or drop off some good food or dessert for me at St. Charles Hospital, I'd be happy to eat it live. And I'm probably going to leave this live stream run because at this point, I'm pretty much like on the verge of losing my social sanity. So I think I might start doing origami. Yeah, actually,
calling. Can I help you?
Yeah. Is it possible for me to get, like, a couple pages of, like, blank computer paper? Yeah, I wanted to, like, I don't know, do some origami or something.
Okay. Great. I'll give that to you.
Awesome. Thank you. Well, we'll see how this goes. Oh, I have no idea. I've peed in buckets. So, what questions do you guys have? I mean, about how this whole thing goes? Because trust me, I'm in the midst of it. So, I can tell you anything you need to know, anything you need, anything you are concerned about or unsure of. The thing is, they just don't know a lot about anything right now. But they're very polite and try to take me through everything. So, I'll take these fucking gallons of water. But make sure you're, you know, I was actually, oh, fuck. So many calls. Hello? Uh-huh. You know what? Yeah, probably like a pencil and then like, I can have scissors, right? But yeah, I'm not in a psych ward, so yeah. You know what? Let me just get a pencil would be great because I can always just tear down the line. Awesome. I'm gonna waddle myself over the door. Awesome. Thank you. Bye. Boom. All right. So I'm gonna start making some more origami shapes. But, you know, I've been doing these different things. So what are you guys doing? How's it out in the world? How's everybody else doing? Oh, there's people responding. Okay, sorry. I'm not good at that. The morphine's got me all effed up. It's a habit. I do look like I'm wearing a habit. Yeah. So I have, like I said, I've got pneumonia in both my lungs that they're currently treating. Luckily, the COVID, it's not positive. So they are going to test it again just to make sure they release me out into the world again so I can go sit at home again. Oh, my. Oh, I love you, Kathy, and oh, look at all these people. Yeah, see, it's a pharaoh look. I knew you knew what it was. Mm-hmm. All right, let's see. Oh, what's going on? I'm watching Dirty Dancing. I watched both Miss Congenialities. Love that. Let's see. And no, I am COVID negative. I am just very sick. You know, actually, I had a fever for over a week and then the breathing started. My chest got really tight. So that, for me, for you guys, I would definitely monitor your breathing. The fever, I couldn't keep it down with the acetaminophen, but they did say, and this has come from my lung doctor, my infectious disease doctor, and from the other doctor, do not take ibuprofen if you think you have COVID. Now, regular flu, that doesn't matter, but acetaminophen is the way to go. Yeah. Hold on. Oh my God. Nope. My paper in. Okay, my lungs are terrible. My lungs hurt so bad. Yeah, my lungs do not feel good. But yeah, who knows? There's these moments they've been keeping me with my anxiety. Been very kind enough to give me a little low dose of Ativan, keep me from losing my marbles. And with this bed, where you can sit like this. Oh my god, I want one for the house. It's so comfortable. Just under different conditions, I'd rather be here. So I'm gonna change this up. But yeah, like I said, I'm out of St. Charles, so I can't have visitors, obviously. But if anybody would like to bring me cake or non-hospital food, I would be super appreciative. I like really anything. Any kind of cake, anything that's not hospital food would be great. And yeah. So we could go. Oh man, I would kill for a cupcake right now. Seriously. I just would die. Oh. Alright. There. No. Can I breathe okay, Kelsey? No. Not really. Oh, my friend Yasser. Here. Take this phone call. Okay, Kelsey, let me answer your question. Hello?
Dang, what the heck happened?
Oh, you know, just... I was huffing paint, you know how I do.
Oh my gosh, dude, I'm so sorry to hear it.
No, started with a fever, and then I got sick. So I got more sick, and then I just went downhill really fast, and then basically to the point where I couldn't breathe, and that's when I went to the hospital. That's when I recommend anybody going to the hospital is when the breathing, because... Because if you can get in, luckily I'm not on a ventilator and I don't have to be. So, not
fuck,
have.
Dude.
Well, because if you don't have to be on a ventilator, if you don't have to be on a ventilator, that's when you get the permanent damage to your lungs. So,
yeah, that's what I heard.
Yeah.
And so you're an active case.
No, I'm negative for COVID.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah.
Man, that's okay, though.
I was like, yay, pneumonia. It was very weird. I was like, everybody was like, my doctor was like, yeah, you want to definitely have pneumonia. I'm like, yeah. It's kind of like.
I can't believe, man. So what hospital are you at now?
St. Charles.
St. Charles, okay. Yeah, well, shit, dude. I'm sorry to hear it. I hope you get better.
Yeah.
Fuck,
well,
man.
If you guys want to bring me any kind of food or anything, you can.
I can?
Yeah. So I've got, I think Megan from Benchmark was going to bring me some food.
Send me from Jed's and I'll bring it to you.
Oh, from Jed's? I can have wings?
Ooh. Yeah, you can have whatever. Yeah, send me what you want and I'll bring it to you. I'll probably bring it to you tomorrow.
Oh, nice. I'm going to blow this bathroom up.
Yeah. Send me your order. I'll get it for you, and I'll stop by and bring it to you.
Perfect. Well, I appreciate it, buddy.
Yeah, just tell me how I have to get it inside.
Yeah, you just take it to the main lobby at the front desk and tell them it's for room.
Okay. Can you send me all that in a text so I can just take care of it fast?
2040. Yeah, I will.
Oh, awesome, man. Thanks again. I hope you get better, man. I'll quickly call you.
All right. Sounds good, buddy.
All right, brother. Thanks, man.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay. So... question about my breathing. Who was it? Kelsey. Is my paper here? Aw, yeah. Come get my paper.
I'm coming.
Be back. This is fantastic. So I asked the one doctor if I could have wine, and he said no, so they got me this. Cheers. Aw. There's a little. Alright. Well, got my paper. And some scissors, with some origami, yeah, some arts and crafts. All right. I think I'm a mental patient, and here talking to myself. I'm like, no, I'm talking to all my friends, all around the country, well, all around Ohio. Oh, okay. Let's see. Okay, I do want to answer Kelsey's question. My breathing, it's like a really tight burning sensation. I can do shallow breaths. Whenever I get up and have to walk any more than 10 feet, I get right now. It's hard to catch my breath, so I have to be careful how much I am moving about up. It's more like bending over, you know, going in vertical. Vertically is what I got to kind of watch more than anything. Ugh, I need another workstation.
What?
That there. Here we go. I'm gonna adjust this. Ooh. Working with. Let's get set up here. Okay. All right. I love them. They're so funny. All right. So my breathing, it really hasn't gotten any better. I'm on azithromycin to try to treat it right now. I'm on also a dose of morphine to help with the pain. The biggest problem that I've had, if I get emotional during this, just bear with me. It's been a long 10 days. So, you know, obviously I miss being home. I miss being home. They don't know what's wrong. but it's not COVID, so I don't have corona, so I'm trying to figure out what it is. Sorry. I'm really tired. I've been doing this for over 10 days, and I'm really wore out. But I think it's gonna be fine. And you know me, I always try to find the ridiculous silver lining in everything that I do. And that's what I'm here to do. I mean, I miss everybody so much. But no, I don't have corona. And it's not corona, it's COVID-19. Just to clarify. I miss my husband, you know, and I miss him. Someone like me who thrives with other people and the interactions with other people and seeing people, it's very difficult. It's very hard. But, you know, I'm where I need to be. I'm where I need to be. Get myself a t-shirt. Just add it to the list. The breathing we do every night. We start with the antibiotics and go from there. Every morning I wake up, my fever is 101. Today it was 100.8. So it's going down a little bit, but that's kind of their biggest concern, is that I don't have COVID-19. And we're not sure what my body is fighting. So they're swabbed again. Please, please God. But what happened is I was on Wednesday night, I was sitting at home. And it hit me really hard. The Tylenol quit taking down my fever. I was sitting at 102.6, 102.7. And at that point, I went straight to the hospital, walk in, and just broke down. And it's more of, I'm not crying because I'm sad. I'm crying. I'm just physically exhausted. You know, you're not sleeping. And every time you do sleep, you wake up every 2-3 hours because you're just saturated in puddles of sweat. To the point where I had dreams that I was laying in a swamp. You know, when you get up and you're just soaked, even down to your ankles. And, you know, I went in and they had me there and they ran some tests and. Actually, they didn't do the COVID test in the first place. They just did some x-rays on my lungs, and that's when they told me they have what's called the shattered glass pneumonia. And from there, the shattered glass pneumonia in my lungs, and then along with the fever being over 100, and that was all the signs point to corona. So they shipped me out to St. Charles, where I'm at now, where the staff has been very, very kind and very nice. And from there, they just ran a shit ton of tests. Oh, I love needles. Never had so many pricks and prods. But, you know, we got to keep each other safe. And this is, I think, my... I'm not going to sit on a high horse here, but there's people. I was in ICU for a couple days, and then they moved me over here. I know the other problem with having a fever this high for a long period of time is my memory is really bad. I forget what you tend to blur days together, and you forget kind of when what happened when. So we got this nice beard coming in. I'm like, no, I might go ahead and leave it. But I mean, there's not much you can do. You know, you just have to be compliant and listen to your doctors. But, you know, I think that's why the whole, you know, they said that my risk factors didn't add up. So when I told them my risk factors of how long I had been home, because I started getting sick right before my birthday, feeling a little under the weather, I never once left the house, you know. And so, you know, because I just wanted to do the right thing. And, you know, I'm going to go out on a limb here and just say, I'm just not selfish enough for the, if people think it's not a big deal, you know, I think that's not really your call to say that. Because they don't know what this is. I'm still here. I just tested negative, but even with the negative test, it's 70% reliant. And yet my body is still reeling. So for those people that can't just stay in place or just have enough courtesy for other people, like, I just don't get you. Like, I don't get it. I'm not the type of person to make very definitive statements, but I think it's fucking selfish. There are people in this hospital that are compromised, that have immunity, that is compromised. And all it takes is for you to go down and start feeling bad and come here, and guess what? Those people, you'll come out of it, but they don't. And again, the whole situation sucks. But having said that, aw, Derek Bauman, I miss you, buddy. I am out of ICU. Oh my goodness. I am gonna do something new now. Time to shake his hair out. Ooh. Oh. How's that? Oh. So, well, yeah, so I'm asking for if anybody wants to bring me some cake or some wings or anything, I will take it. I can't have flowers and I can't have balloons. I already asked. I did ask for the wine. Dr. Chopra said, no, I'm not allowed to have wine. Whatever. But that's okay. So, do you guys have any questions? I'm sure everybody has questions. It's very much like they have guidelines on certain things, how to treat it, but for the most part, they don't have, you know, once you're tested positive, then they've got like different treatments. But like I said, my biggest concern is I'm negative. So they're testing me again because my fever level is still so high. My body's fighting something. Even though it is, you know, I do have pneumonia in both my lungs, but let's just hope it's just pneumonia. But I just am going insane here because I really don't know when this is gonna stop, or when it's gonna be over, when I can go home, you know, and the safety of my home. Oh, Derek, I am at St. Charles up in Oregon, Ohio, in Toledo, where I live. In Toledo. Oh, man. So, you guys are making my day. You know, this is actually Eric's idea. Eric told me you could hear how loud I was and how sad my voice was. And he told me that he's like, you should just do a live video and see how many people actually are out there, you know, thinking about shit. And he's right. You guys are awesome. Well, all right, no more tears. I've got to get my head wrap done again. What am I going for this time? What are we doing? Let's see. What do we want to... Thank you, Kayla. Oh, Rachel from Texas. I got love coming in from all over. Oh, I love you, Jenna. Oh, anybody have any? Yes, thank God it's not it. So, oh Lord, have mercy. Chiquita banana. Oh, chiquita banana. Wait. It's like a hot dog.
Oh yeah, get it.
Okay. Yeah, that's fucking cute. Ooh, I like this. Who is she though? Oh, chiquita banana. I do a 5-minute stand-up set. Miss Jenna, my little cousin from Texas, I love you. Yes, I don't have COVID-19. So, well, at least the first test came back negative. They're doing the second test, which I'll find out tomorrow. So, it'll be a whole other tomorrow of this. I would love to do a stand-up. I think I just got to kind of get it composed. My brain's a little between the fever and the morphine. Well, let's see. You know what? Ooh, these fun tools they gave me. Fuck shit up. Oh, yeah. Fuck it up. I'm not that great with technology all the time. So, oh man, I thought I'd have all this content to talk to you guys about, but I think I just wanted to talk to somebody who wasn't my nurses. Oh, spots. Oh, nothing. I am in the hospital. I have pneumonia in both my lungs, and I've got very high-grade fever and have for 10 days, and I have been hospitalized here since Wednesday, and they're still trying to figure out what it is. So I tested negative for COVID-19 for the first test, but they said 70% of those tests are inaccurate. And the doctor, he goes, he's like, 70%. He goes, 70% of the tests are negative. So that means out of 100 people, I was like, does that mean that like 70 would have an accurate test? I know maths. Thanks. Try not to be a smart ass, but. I like water. Water is better. Alright. I wonder if the nurses out there can hear me talking to myself. They're probably like, oh, we can have a 10-13. And strap me down. What if I can get better drugs that way? Maybe. Well, ooh, let's see what they gave me. Presents! Ooh, who's texting me? Do you know what? It's not your turn. I'm trying to fill out my application for ooh, that's cute. Look at that. Ooh, look at that. That's so cute. Look at that. I got like a reverse little mullet going on here. Yes, a little rat tail. Idiot. Oh my. Oh, let's see. Blah, blah, blah. I guess we have some updates coming. We're currently trying to pitch the show that I was working with Brett on and Glenn. But obviously, since the shutdown, we've kind of had to postpone the whole thing. But that'll be coming. That's still working. Well, so I'm stuck here in the hospital. I'm really kind of digging this look. Let's see. How do these Facebook Live videos even work? I don't even really know. Right now. Starting to get hot again. I start to get really, really hot, and then I get really dizzy. So, all joking aside, I'm just trying to stay positive, trying to stay, silver lining, but I don't know. I've been doing a lot of deep thinking lately about things that really do matter, and how you put so much emphasis, we all do it, on different things. And as long as you're doing things for the right reasons and you are doing it for yourself, to better yourself and to better those around you, I realized that, like, as hard as we work, as hard as Eric and I have worked, as hard as a lot of you guys work, my family works. There's just sometimes you just gotta stop and just appreciate the health that you have and appreciate that you have somebody to share it with. And it's definitely making me look at things a little bit different. Because, I mean, I literally was Howie Mandel about it. The second we got the order to come down, you know, I was like, no, I'm not leaving the house. Like, I'm not doing anything. I'm not talking to anybody. This makes me sound like a dick, but I don't care. Like, I didn't even let the housekeepers come in the house, like, for weeks. I was like, no, not doing it. Not at all. You know, just like shut it down. And then, you know, you just realize that, God, these people, so much shit doesn't fucking matter. So much bullshit doesn't matter. Like, it doesn't. Like, I watch people go at each other for no reason. And, you know, I'm like, I get to be right to the point, but to create tension between other people. You know, I was noticing that, obviously we all have since the age of social media, but, you know, like I don't, I don't feel that there's any accomplishment or something or material possession that I could achieve, attain, or have that I would over any one of you. You know, and it's not, you don't always think that way. You know, the thought of a new car, the thought of buying another business, the thought of traveling, the thought of an Instagram post, you know, it's fine. I think, you know, it's all kind of part of the game of life. One thing I can take away from all of this right now, I have no fucking choice right now. If they can't, you know, with my lungs feeling the way they do, it doesn't give a shit about where I live or any of that. And it made me realize that, you know, I just want to try to be a kinder person. And really bring joy to everybody I try to meet, you know, and stop being so cynical and stop being so kind of arrogant at times and stuck up my own ass. Hi, Dee. Oh, Jamie, tell Dee I said hello. Hi, Leslie. So, y'all like my mullet? It's so cute. Oh, it's my mom. Hello. Hi. Yeah. Am I what? I'm broadcasting from my hospital bed.
That's funny. Yes. I'm just like trying to break my fever and sweat to death.
Are you not feeling good, Mom?
Yes, I'm strapped.
So another swab for me, and then they're gonna do another swab, so I should have that back by tomorrow. And then if at that time I get a double negative, then they will feel confident enough that it's not COVID, and then they will let me just get treated for the pneumonia. But they're going to switch my antibiotic today because I'm still having the shortness of breath. I'm still having trouble breathing. My lungs still really bad. And I'm still having a fever, which is really odd because I've had a fever now for 10 days.
Yeah. What's the fever running, like, low?
It's... it's about 100 to 102.
Yeah. I mean, I'm miserable at, like, 100.
Yeah, and then not being able to breathe.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that'll... Yeah, that sucks. What is that mine? They went testing mine for COVID, but I don't think it. I think mine's just stress.
Yes.
It presents itself different with everyone, so they want to double check, make sure.
Yeah. Yeah. I will never take this off my head. Yeah. Well, I sound better because of the morphine. It helps. She's like, how are you feeling? I'm like, I can smell yellow. Oh no, I didn't show you. So anybody who's just joined in, they gave me this. I asked for wine. I asked my doctor if I could have wine and they said no. So they gave me this instead. They gave me a printed off glass of wine that says best we could do. But I think I'm going to start making origami. Yeah, they gave me paper and suture removals and stuff and tweezers and gauze. No. Nope. I felt very isolated. Yeah. Oh, good. So, I know. Yeah. All righty. I will. I'll let you know. Love you. Bye. Oh. Well, nice of music. Oh wait, you know what? I need to buck up, Buttercup. Let's see. You know what? I have unlimited data. I've got a picture of wine. I am ready. Ooh, where's my dope playlist? Oh yeah, you follow my playlist on Spotify. You listen to all the taste of music I have. No, the doctors aren't hot. It's Toledo, Leslie. Drunk. Of course, I'm in my own room. They don't let me around other people. Ooh. Fuck boy. Actually, the one nurse, Todd, was really nice. Oh. Probably not appropriate. Oh. tests are good.
Father boy tryna play my homie, but 2020 I'ma take time on me. Out the window where my main line goes, this is sacrilegious how I'm gon' feed on me. Birthday comes in many forms. Birthday opens any door.
Oh, I love you, Lindsay.
Never seen this distance. For success, my life is on the screen. If you heard it on my line, and if you're doing good, it's not like I don't care.
I am right.
I wanna see the world. Same if you breathe your air. Fuck a poet tryna play my homie, but 2020 I'ma take time on me. Out the window where my main line goes, this sacrilegious how I'm gon' feed off IT. Can you find someone who can be invested? I'm not over you, that's not my objective. So obsessed with my mistakes, I gotta accept. I'm not gonna listen to always wants a little more.
Music while I'm Facebook live streaming, can I do that where it's not going to bother Mike of me talking to you? Thanks! It's my headgear. I was looking up different types of head wraps. Oopsie. Oh. Oh. All right. La 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 la. Well, I'm going to be here all day. You guys can feel free to pop in and out of the channel. I'm going to leave it running. So, I ain't got nothing else to do. Yo. Ooh, I wonder if I can do like a side wrap. Ooh! The camera's backwards, so I'm trying to grab stuff. This is ridiculous. That's good. This is Deborah. She's Deborah. Ah, wow. This tape. This hurts. I'm allergic. Alright. So I start to get. Ugh. I need more. Boy. Thanks, Lori. I'm in here because I've got pneumonia in both my lungs. They thought that I had COVID. I had all of it. Hold on. I get winded really easily because of both my lungs. I have crushed glass pneumonia in my lungs. So I had a high fever, so anybody who's just looking, tuning in, I had a high fever, and then the breathing is what really concerned me. So the breathing started on Monday, this last Monday, and then from there, I just had to come in and my fever was like 103, and they've been trying to fix it ever since. My COVID test came back negative, but they said 70% only chance, so they're gonna do it again. But yeah, my breathing sucks, man. It's like tight and it hurts, and so it's like I can't breathe in too deep. Like they said, the one test you can do is take in a full deep breath and hold it for 10 seconds without coughing. I can't do that. So, they are, actually, they'll be in this evening. They're going to test me again for COVID. So, once I can have two negative tests, then they'll just treat me for the pneumonia, and then from there, I hopefully can go home and quarantine in my own house, please. I do like this new hat, though. I might take this with me. Georgette, you missed it. Georgette, hold on. Look. So I actually had them. I had them ask if I could have wine, and they called my infectious disease doctor, and he said no. So the nurses gave me this instead.
Thank you.
I know. I was like, you know me, I can't. I'm a fuck off. I can't help that. I'm like, the facts of life are the facts of life are the facts of life. But it doesn't mean you can't have a little bit of fun along the way. Oh, what do I need? I need to have a lunch. I'm actually good right now. I don't know. Origami. Alright guys, so I'm gonna... how long? No. Well, they said... No, they have not. Well, they... I got admitted Wednesday. They said if that test comes back negative again, then they haven't really told me a definitive answer. So, and yes, I am in a personal room. It's very, very private. And I have this, here, look, I've got this thing here. Keeps my air nice and purified for me. So, you know. So, it's actually, yeah, at my own entire room, which has a bathroom and a shower in it, so at least whenever I have some energy, I can shower. But, oh, yeah, always double dip it. Alright. Origami. Let's do it. If there's any children around, you may want to mute the microphone. I have no idea what is outside the window. Yeah. My flare is always intact. Bound. I can't be fancy right now. Ooh, ooh. Ooh. I'm gonna do a butterfly. Okay. Bitch, I'm the queen of drag. Drag queen. Bitch, I'm the queen of drag. I'm the bitch. Hello, Brenda. I don't have COVID, but I do have pneumonia. But they're testing me again for it because all my symptoms point to Oh. That's all my wine. Yeah, bro. Style. Oh, the paper. Lord, my doc. I asked my doctor. I actually paged him, asked if I could have wine. He said no. So the nurses gave me this instead. Hold it. Hot dog style. They said, I asked for Galata, they said it doesn't last as long. That's why I got some more food instead. Fold the top quarter. I guess. I had to sneak in my personalities. RuPaul's getting me through this quarantine. skeet. Oh, shit's about to get crazy. Wait. It was supposed to be a square piece of paper. Fuck it. It's a goose. All right. Let's try again. I'm gonna take a quick intermission and I'm back. I'll leave the rest. I'll get this. What else do I have to do? BRB. Okay. Alright. Back to my origami. Origami. Huh? No internet connection detected. Ooh. Ooh! Levity. It's a fine. Oh well, have you been on my cellular device? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? I'm finding it. Oh. Ooh. Don't put it in your mouth, you don't know where it's been. I can't. Oh, I love this song by Troy Boy.
Yes.
Oh, well. Oh. Oh, they have dragons. Let's start easier. Amphibian. To a frog. I remember how to make a square. Hello, Steven. Thank you for my surgery tool.
I'm going to make sure I do it.
Open the top flap of paper, over to the right. Please have a drink.
Do it.
Do it for me. This doesn't make any sense. They sent me to St. Charles. I didn't have a choice. Because I had the symptoms of COVID, so this is where they send you if you're American.
Thank you.
what they call a squash bulb. That is not a squash bulb. There's a way better way to describe it. Or origami website. It's a camel. Oh, oh my god. All right, I gotta find something else to do live. What can we do? This origami website's terrible. Time is it? I'm starting to feel like shit again. Ugh. Comes in waves. Ugh. Stay safe. So I'll talk to y'all soon. Bye.